Welcome back to the Ringside Review. This is your boy Bruce Lee. I just wanted to touch on couple of fights this past weekend, just a little weekend recap briefly, and the upcoming bout between Lucien Bute and John Paul, Mendy. Yes, Mendy from France. And Paul Williams comeback fight against Lara. I'm not going to pronounce dude's first name because, to be honest, it would be a massacre. But anyway, I just wanted to touch over the big fight over the past weekend, the heavyweight championship fight. Yeah. You see my face right now? You see my face right about now? I bought into the Wolf tickets. Yeah, I bought Mr. Hayes Wolf tickets. And he showed up and did absolutely nothing. Nothing. The man blames it on a toe injury. Yo, David, you're making me look bad. I had my first prediction gone wrong, put it like that, this past week because of you and your toe, supposedly. But I'm not hating on my first incorrect answer on my prediction. I'm just hating on Mr. Hay selling the Wolf tickets, which I bought. I'm going to be honest. I bought the Wolf tickets. He showed up and did absolutely nothing. But at the end of the fight, he couldn't say Klitschko, you know, it was a good, you know, he's a good champion, a good fighter. I lost to I'm not going to say great. I'm not even going to throw that out there. I lost to a good fighter today. He didn't even have, he said it's his toe. Come on now, his toe? His toe. David, you just lost, okay? Put it like that. Quit making excuses. Take it like a man and move on to the next one. But I just want to say I bought the Wolf tickets. My prediction was wrong. I had Hay winning in 12 with a unanimous decision. Well, split decision. Anyway, the bottom line, it was a loss. It ended up going the other way with Klitschko winning by unanimous decision in 12. He retains his Ring Magazine, IBF, WBO, and IBO heavyweight titles. Also, I want to touch a little bit on the Friday night fight recap. main event. I want to recap that for a little bit. That was between Milligan and Lujan. The first four rounds, Milligan was in control of the fight, with Lujan taking the third or fourth round from Milligan. Anyway, he got one of those four rounds, but it was looking good for Milligan. He was throwing nice, crisp left hand straight to Lujan's face. And actually, to be honest, there were some hard shots. I was feeling them through the TV screen, but Lujan must have drunk some Jason Voorhees juice or something. You know, that's the dude from Friday the 13th, for y'all who don't follow horror movies. But, yeah, he must have been on some Jason Voorhees type stuff. What I mean by that, he was taking a licking, but he still kept coming forward and shaking his head, just shaking it off. I'm like, oh my goodness, this man is crazy. But he showed a lot of heart. He came in and dusted off Milligan past round 5 through, I think, the fight ended in 8 when he won by knockout fashion. And Milligan went down like 2 of those rounds. Well, Milligan was safe for the next 3 rounds. He hit the canvas. And that last time, it was just, I had the same feeling as the ref, to be honest. After that last knockdown, I was thinking in my head, stop the fight for this dude to get killed. But the ref went ahead and stepped in and waved off the fight in 8. Giving a knockout to Lujan, was on that Jason Voorhees juice, but that was a good fight. He took a lot of good blows. I mean, some solid blows, but was shaking it off. I mean, just he was shaking his head like, "You're not hurting me, son." I think they got in the head of Milligan, you know, during the fight, but that psychologically messed him up. He didn't know what to do. He was like, "Oh God, this man won't stop. He won't stop coming towards me." But anyway, Lujan wins by KO on the Friday Night Fights main event. Let me jump back to the heavyweight division. I officially announced it dead. I mean, it was dead before, but I had I guess false hope that Mr. Hale was going to inject some life into it. But I come today to bury the heavyweight division, as there is no one else left out there for the Klitschko brothers. I mean, no one. I even had a crazy thought that Thomas Adamek would somehow hang in there with Vitaly, coming in September. But I, as of right now, well, I'll get my official prediction later, but I can lay it out there now. It'll be Klitschko, Vitaly Klitschko. I would say maybe late round knockout by or unanimous decision. But anyway, the heavyweight division is officially dead, in my opinion. To me, it is. It's gone bye-bye. Dang. That's all I can say, man. If anybody's out there listening and looking to this, any heavyweight fighter out there, I mean, if you have some heart, please show up. All I want to see is somebody with some heart that go up in the ranks and to face these brothers. I mean, not lay down like a bunch of dogs, man. I mean, David talked about all the previous opponents just showing up to collect the paycheck. I think he did the same himself. But anyway, yeah, if any fighter out there, listen to me. Wake up. Wake up. It is possible. These guys are not unbeatable. It is possible to win. You just got to show us some heart. Show me some heart. Anybody out there. All right, I'm going to get off my soapbox. I'm going to get off my soapbox on that. I'll move on to my first prediction. We have Paul Williams coming back to face the Puerto Rican Lara from Puerto Rico. Paul Williams is his first fight back since being knocked out by Martinez for the WBC middleweight championship. He lost by knockout last fight. Actually, for Lara, he didn't look that impressive to me. Actually, he didn't look impressive at all. He had a fight against Carlos Molina back on Friday Night Fights here back in March. He got a draw out of it. Actually, I don't know if he underestimated Molina or what, but he didn't impress me at all. I mean, Molina took the fight to him, and he ended up earning a draw, which, in my opinion, I think, to be honest, I think Molina won by at least a couple of points. By a couple of points. It was a close fight. I mean, it could have swung either way, but I would have gave the nod to Molina. But they ended up giving them a draw. So we have him, he's coming off a lackluster performance on the Friday Night Fights main event against Carlos Molina, Lara, that is. So he fights Paul Williams this Saturday. Paul Williams is ranked by number 4 by the WBC, not in the ring rankings. He's not ranked by the Ring magazine as of yet in this division. And we have Lara, he's ranked number 13 by the WBC and number 6 by the IBF. I just don't see it. To be honest, I just don't see. I know how they do the rankings. Well, whoever you beat, that's whoever you switch out ranks with. I mean, that's how they do it, but oh my goodness, who was ranked that high, and how did Lara beat him? Anyway, long story short, I think Paul Williams will go ahead and take this fight by unanimous decision. He'll go ahead and beat Lara and give him his first loss of his career, which he will bounce back from. I have no doubts about it. But I'm going with Paul Williams by unanimous decision, P. Will. The next fight, the last fight I wanted to make a little prediction on was the Butte and Jean-Paul Mendy fight coming up this Saturday. This is for the IBF Super Middleweight Championship. The previous fight I just gave my prediction on was in the junior middleweight division. But this fight for Butte, he's the IBF Super Middleweight Champion. So this will be for his belt coming up, 12-round fight this Saturday. For this fight, I believe Butte will go ahead and win by late knockout or unanimous decision, but I'm leaning towards more of a late knockout. I'm going late knockout. Put that down. Late knockout by Butte. Reason being on that, Mendy's last fight he had against, Biker? How do you pronounce his last name? Saikio Biker. That was IBF title eliminator to face Butte. which Biker had to fight. I mean, it is in the first round. Biker knocked Mindy down, but when Mindy was on her knee, Biker was still swinging and just knocked him cold for a few minutes. And I believe that's still in that guy's head, you know. I mean, it was a cheap shot. I mean, dude did take a knee. He should have just backed up off of him, but I believe that's in Mindy's head. That, you know, he got punched on his knee, you know, that basically it's still translating to a knockout to me. I mean, psychologically. So that's why I'm going with Butte, because he will pick this guy apart. In my opinion, he'll find his spots. They're both southpaws. Butte will find his spots and take this guy out pretty late. So I'm going with Butte with a late round knockout or TKO in this fight. He retains his IBF super middleweight championship. Also, some side notes, Kimbo Slice will finally make his boxing debut at 37 years of age. He fights August 13th in here in Miami, Miami, as we pronounce it, Oklahoma. He will go ahead and fight. I don't know who his opponent will be, but he finally makes his pro debut. I read somewhere where he was going to do it last year, but he had some, you know, he was ready to go. But he had some last-second thoughts that he didn't want to do it, so he pulled out. So he's finally going to make his in-ring debut on August 13th. And another side note, in the still heavyweight division, man, I'm just sick to my stomach every time I say heavyweight. Y'all got to forgive me, man, because I really am sick to my stomach. So please forgive me when I say heavyweight division. Whew, I thought I just tasted chili right there. I just had chili a few hours ago, and I almost regurgitated it. But anyway, Cristobal Arreola is back in action this Saturday on the Paul Williams undercard. He faces Friday. Don't know the guy's last name, to be honest. Know how to pronounce it. Please forgive me. But Cristobal Arreola will be in action on the Paul Williams undercard. Paul Williams and Lara undercard. And before I get out of here, I just wanted to give you a little nugget here. IBF rankings in the super middleweight division since Butte's fight is this Saturday. I'll stick with the theme since he's defending his title. Ranked number one, of course, is Jean-Paul Mindy, who he's facing this Saturday. Ranked number two, not rated. Ranked number three is Pablo Ferris from Argentina. Number four, we have Don George from the United States. And number five, Peter Quinlan from the U.S. But that's all I have for you today on this edition of the Ringside Review. Until next time, peace out.